Hey beauties, it's Viviana and today I am so freaking excited for what we're about to attempt today. So, I not too long ago posted my video on the waveformers and I'm really glad that a lot of you guys are enjoying the look as much as I did. Y'all are making me blush. Stop it! But other than all the flattering comments, there was one other comment that caught my attention and it clearly did catch a lot of y'all attention as well because it got a lot of thumbs up. Imagine this product but entirely straight. A 100% heatless straightener method that actually makes your hair smooth. And if you are familiar with this channel, any at all, then you know that all I need is a little bit of curiosity and we're here today. We are going to try and turn the waveformer into a straightformer. This is really, really exciting for me. Not because I want a 100% heatless straightening tool, but just because the comment was made and I'm now curious about it. So, part of it did get me to imagine this wave former being a tool to straighten the hair, but there was a comment later on that suggested it may be possible to straighten the waveformer by allowing it to melt a little bit under boiling water and then flattening it under a pile of books. And I mean, it is plastic, so it makes sense to me. However, I really, really, really like how the waveformers work and I would like to keep all of my waveformers intact. So I'm only sacrificing one of my waveformers. We both win. I satisfy my curiosity and you get a method of turning waveformers into straightformers. So I have some water boiling in my kitchen right now.
So the question now is, how long is this gonna take to soften up?
Definitely looks looser. You see that? Yup, the wave ain't looking as tight as before.
Can you see? Can you see? Can you see? It's practically like cooking noodles.
Like waiting for ramen to finish cooking. Alright, so it's been 4 minutes already, but I'm gonna leave it in for a little longer to see if I can get more of those waves out. Alright, so we're officially at the 5 minute mark and I can still see a few waves in the waveformer. Wonder if it need any assistance fully straightening.
So this is some real backyard scientific experiment. I realized that I needed some help getting out the tiny bit of waves left back in the waveformer. So I decided to use my chopstick and pin it right at the dents. And at this point, I was just hoping that it will get the final bit of waves out of the waveformer. Listen, I'm working with what I have. We don't judge each other here on this channel, okay? So after about the next 2 minutes of allowing the waveformer to soak in the boiling water some more, it looks like it helped. So I'm just going to do the same thing to the next half of the waveformer.
This would have been so much easier if I had a wide enough pot to boil the water in while the waveformer was fully stretched.
There it is. The straight formal. Not entirely like straight, but come on. So from what I've observed, you cannot go the extra mile and try and get your waveform as straight as I've gotten it, which isn't bad at all. But at around the 7 minute mark, the waves were so loose that I think if you use the waveformer, the straight formal, in your hair at that point, I think the waves will be so loose enough that it could pass as straight. So some persons might be curious and want to know, why didn't I flatten the now straight formal under a pile of books after I boiled it? And the simple answer to that is, this material that the waveformer is made from loses heat very easily. Like, as soon as I took the waveformer out of the boiling water, I was able to fully touch the material without any burns, any heat, any at all coming from it. So that told me that if I was supposed to transfer the waveformer straight out of the boiling pot, I would not have enough time to put it under a pile of books for that heat from the boiling water to be effective. Basically, if I was supposed to go with the pile of book method, then I would just be flattening the waveformer under a pile of books while this is still cold. Because that's what it would be right after I take it out of the boiling water. Cold. So, yeah. I'll be doing a process called cold forming, and that would take a long time. It would just be the pressure of the books flattening the waveformer over time. So the best method was to try and get the waveformer as straight as possible while it was still in the boiling water. And that was my limitation. I didn't have a big enough pot to fully boil a straightened waveformer. So fun part. We're going to give this a try. I'm ensuring my hair is soaking wet and fully detangled. I know my hair is in the waveformer, but unlike when I did the waves, this does feel very loose. Look there. It already slipped away from my roots. Yeah. It just keeps slipping more and more. So basically, there is no friction to hold the waveformer in place. And because it's straight, it's just gonna slide out. All right, I have two ideas. Let's first add more hair into the section, because for some reason, that looked like it could use a lot more hair. So that was a lot more hair, but it still feels as if it's going to slide down. So, my solution. I have lots and lots of bobby pins. I'm gonna use a bobby pin to pin down the waveformer close to my root. Okay. And can you see where my hair falls? Alright, so my hair is right here in the straight formal, and I can see it has a little bit of texture still, just a little bit. But I think that's supposed to can still work. I don't know, you know, but let us see how it dries. And yeah, this is gonna be interesting. Okay, so I've allowed my hair to dry for hours now, and I think we can finally pull out this straight formal and see what it did to our hair. Well, did to my hair. Ooh, I still can see my own texture peeking through a little bit, but remember we did use larger sections of hair to prevent the straight formal from sliding off. So all right, let's brush it out and let's see what it really looks like. Wow, whoa, okay. Wow. Wow. Can you see? It looks blow dried. I was kind of hoping for more of a pressed look, but come on, I can't complain about this. I wouldn't have been too mad at my straight formal if it didn't stretch the hair this well, because I kind of felt like my hair didn't have enough tension inside the straight formal. But I ain't mad at these results. If I was a person who found it necessary to stretch my hair every single week and I didn't want to use heat to stretch my hair every single week, I would actually invest the money into buying a few packs of these wave formers and turning them into straight formers. But trying out this one was good enough for me. I just wanted to experiment. Anyway, beauties, I hope you enjoyed this video and give me a thumbs up if you did. I enjoyed filming this video for idleness sake, but it could have been beneficial for someone out there. So you should probably share this video. If you're new to my channel and you haven't decided from this one video that you want to subscribe, but you're thinking to go watch another one of my videos, but you don't want to subscribe, you know what? I'm going to help you out. I'm going to list a few of my more interesting videos up in the iCards so you can watch, get more familiar with my channel, and then if you can sit down through 2 or 3 of my videos, that should be a really good indicator that, I mean, you enjoy my content and it just makes sense you subscribe. Okay, beauties, thanks again for watching. Later!